It was Colorado's worst wildfire season in a decade. In 2012, 4,167 Colorado wildland fires raged across the parched terrain. Flames destroyed more than 648 structures, killed six people, burned more than 384,803 acres, and caused at least $538 million in property losses. Tens of thousands of residents evacuated their homes. Favorite tourist sites closed, obscured by smoke and haze, lifting Colorado's economic damages to the stratosphere. Often, the flames and smoke were so intense that firefighters could not tell where the fire was, what it was doing, and what was threatened.
Engine 43, this is the smoke attack, County Road 44 and 27. The informant says she thinks she saw smoke on the ridge about 30 minutes ago. She had to drive some distance to get cell coverage. Nothing further, no second report.
Some hours later, despite sending out several engines and a traditional spotting aircraft, no fire has been found, and the fire department stands down.
Dispatch, engine 3. At this point, we've been looking for a while. We're unable to locate. We'll be available, returning to quarters. We'll be back out tomorrow to search again.
This is a common story for lightning-caused fires. A single tree will smolder, but because the ground around the tree is wet, it will not spread. Often that fire will show up mid-morning the next day as the ground dries. However, this particular fire is not common. The next morning, as the sun rises, the fire rapidly grows.
CR fire rifle in the area of 2 miles northwest of intersection County Road 44 and 27. The area of smoke report yesterday. We now have reports of the smoke column building.
This time, despite best efforts, this fire expands rapidly. Local fire departments respond with all resources and aircraft are ordered. However, the fire consumes 15,000 acres on the first day, growing to over 43,000 the next. 3,000 people are evacuated for nearly 3 weeks. One person dies and over 250 homes are destroyed, along with countless other buildings. During the fire, two other major wildland fires and multiple small ones rage in Colorado, further taxing firefighting capability. This may sound familiar to you. The difference now is technology. The Colorado Division of Fire Prevention and Control's focus is on early detection and initial attack using multi-mission aircraft. These aerial assets bring a new generation of intelligence and detection capability to the wildfire fight.
Engine 43 is en route. RETA is roughly 40 minutes. Could you contact the MMA and have them respond to this area with their detection and give them the lat and long that I gave you earlier and advise them of the smoke that we see? I will be the ground contact and the radio channel will be VFIRE 21.
Hi, this is Renee from the Division of Fire Prevention and Control Multi-Mission Aircraft.
CSP dispatch relayed your request. Can you please give me the location in lat long, your ground contact, and the radio frequency that they will be on? Yeah, and is there any other information that we're going to need as well?
We'll plan on leaving in about 10 minutes, and it'll be about 15 minutes before we get overhead.
Engine 43 MMA, November 328 Sierra Foxtrot. We're in the area, and we have a visual on your fire. It's going to be a single tree showing little to no smoke, but there is a significant ember wash showing up on the infrared camera. Your lat long is going to be 3952.15 north by 10727.88 west. We've sent the video to your dispatch center and will remain in the area until we see you on scene.
MMA 328SF, engine 43. Hey, we have your lat long that you gave us. We're going to be hiking in. We'll let you know when we make it on scene.
Engine 43, we see you at the fire. Do you need anything else from us?
MMA 328SF, engine 43. Hey, we've made it on scene to the single tree fire. Thank you so much for your help. We wouldn't have been able to find this without you. We'll be able to handle with resources on scene.
The MMA has proven its ability to improve community protection, reduce firefighter exposure, and decrease suppression costs by stopping small fires before they become destructive and unmanageable. The PC-12 is a high-performance turboprop aircraft that can cruise and work safely at altitudes up to 30,000 feet using state-of-the-art infrared sensor technology and onboard computer systems to provide real-time wildfire information to incident commanders and firefighters in the field. The infrared imaging sensors penetrate smoke and detect small wildfires before they grow into significantly larger fires. Instead of sending in ground crews, who may struggle for days to find the source of a fire, as in the case of our example, the planes obtain the fire's location, intensity, and behavior. Sensor operators download this information into the Colorado Wildfire Information Management System, COWIMS, or email the information directly to the firefighter or dispatch center. During the previous fire, the MMA reported the fire and the lat long to the commander over the radio and downloaded video and fire information to COWIMS. However, one of the limitations of current technology is that firefighters on the fire rarely have good connection to the internet and may not have a way to share that information with each other. In addition, incident commanders may not have good intelligence on the location of crews on the fire. One of the Center of Excellence for Advanced Technology Aerial Firefighting's projects is focused on bringing that information directly to the fireground, independent of any cellular or other data connectivity. Using the smartphones that they regularly carry, this project enables incident commanders and crews to share data in remote areas, even in the backcountry where no cell coverage exists. Imagine a wildland fire during early stages. Not a huge fire, but certainly one that is larger than the single tree fire we just saw.
Peak fire IC, November 327 Sierra Foxtrot. I've just created a map showing the perimeter of the fire and some hot spots. I've also marked the location of several structures at the head of the fire that you may want to assign resources to. The road to those structures is shown in blue. I'm going to download that information over the air-to-ground data link right now.
MMA 327 SF. Hey, I see the information on my phone that you sent through of the structures in the head of the fire. Could you go ahead and give me a picture of those structures, please?
Peak fire IC. I've just sent you an image of the structure area. I've marked the main access on your map.
MMA 327 SF. Thank you. Got those pictures. Break. Strike team Alpha. Looking on the phone here, I see that your best place to go protect these structures. Are you able to go en route? And we'll send the information to your phone.
Peak fire IC, strike team Alpha. We have the map on our phone with the access. We're en route, we'll advise.
Armed with real-time data from the MMA and the ability to share that directly with teams on the ground, the incident commander is able to quickly assign teams to respond. Not only that, he or she has information about the structures and the crew's location before even getting a crew there. One of the other challenges with wildland firefighting is predicting what the fire will do quickly. On May 20th, 2015, Governor John Hickenlooper signed House Bill 15-1129 into law. This House bill directs the Colorado Division of Fire Prevention and Control, DFPC, through its Center of Excellence for Advanced Technology Aerial Firefighting, COE, to establish and support a Colorado Wildland Fire Prediction and Decision Support System, CO-FPS. The Center of Excellence has been working with the National Center for Atmospheric Research to operationalize the research known as the COFFEE, or Coupled Atmosphere Wildland Fire Environment. This allows fire managers to utilize resources more effectively, direct evacuations, or even decide not to engage a particular fire. In late 2016, CO-FPS will be entering an experimental stage. Let's see how CO-FPS may change our fire response.
Peak fire IC, November 327 Sierra Foxtrot. I've just received an updated prediction of your fire from CO-FPS. I'm downloading the predicted perimeter for 1, 2, and 3 hours from now to your tablet.
MMA 327 SF. Hey, I see that updated information you sent, and we will be adjusting the evacuations from there. Thank you.
Given this resource, the incident commander can respond more appropriately to a fire. When there are multiple fires going on, fire managers may be able to use CO-FPS simulations to put the right resources on the right fire based upon what we expect to see. In January 2016, the COE held a night aerial firefighting operations summit in Rifle, Colorado, to bring together Colorado and national experts to discuss the prospects of fighting fire from the air at night. Night flying technology developed by the military provides potential for effective and safe night operations. COE is also investigating the use of unmanned aerial systems, drones, on fires in Colorado. These aircraft may provide real benefits to fire operations, ranging from using small, quickly deployed UAVs to scout small fires to using larger, dedicated UAVs to map fires. On the extreme end of UAS technology is the concept of large, optionally piloted aircraft, such as the K-MAX. This heavy helicopter can be operated in two modes, with a pilot on board and in a remotely piloted or autonomous mode. Wildland fire is a part of life in Colorado. Using new and developing technologies, the Colorado Division of Fire Prevention and Control and the Center of Excellence are looking to the future and changing how we respond to wildland fires.